Hey guys, I'm sorry this week's video will be a little bit on the long side and I will sound a little bit pretentious, so forgive me, but I want to have a discussion on the guitar pedal detox. It's been 9 to 10 months that I've done without buying a new guitar pedal, and I'm really proud of that. I always see some of you guys thinking, "Hey, but monochrome dude, like, you have the Big Sky that is 500 bucks and the Boomerang too, and your whole board is like 4 grand, so how can you dare saying that you've not bought any pedals in 9 months? Like, I'm not rich like you, like." And you know what? You're true, I'm 100% with you on that, but what I want to say is that maybe you have to go through the process of buying and selling and trading pedals, but it needs to stop somewhere, okay? And the sooner, the better. And I'm sure some people can relate to this, to buy so many gear, because some people say, "Oh, let the guy do his thing." Like, some people are into gear and some people are into music. And no, it's not okay for me. Gear should always serve music. Like, gear has become a full-time hobby now, and it's not okay. Some guitar pedal companies are so freaking good to give us what we call the GAS, so the gear acquisition syndrome, and they will go like, "Hey, we have a new fuzz pedal that is really analog and fully tweakable, so buy it." So some people will buy it, and 6 months later they will be, "Hey, I know that tens of thousands of people have bought our fuzz pedal, but we have a new one that is even more analog and even more tweakable, and we painstakingly designed it according to the vintage design of the..." Hey, give me a break. It's like in the video games world. Each 4 or 5 years, you have to buy a new console just if you want to play new games. Like, that's why I still play my Nintendo 64 and GameCube, because I don't want to buy the new consoles. But in the gear world, it's every 6 months. Like, it's even becoming a mental illness. You constantly think about gear. And I've been there. Like, I used to spend like 20 hours a week looking for gears, looking for opinions of people of that pedal versus that pedals on the forums, and going on YouTube watching countless of gear review videos, and after going on my local used gear page to see which pedals I could buy or sell or trade, buy, sell, trade, buy, sell, trade. But it needs to stop somewhere. It's like gambling, like you lose yourself in it. And that's why I'm really proud of my 9 to 10 months without buying a new single pedal. And my goal is to reach a year without it. And I'm sure I will succeed, because many good things have happened since then. Now I really know my pedals. Like, when I play, when I plug my guitar, I know exactly what I will get with each of my pedals, and I'm not thinking of what I could have better, or which delay or overdrive will complement better my rig than this pedal. You know, I really know how to use them and I know what I will get with them. Also, I familiarized my ears to my sound. So you can do that too. Familiarize your ears to your sound. When it's been 1 or 2 years with the same gear, your ears start to get accustomed to that particular sound. It becomes part of you as a musician. You are familiar with that sound. If you were to change entirely your gear, you would become lost, because it's not your sound. So if you're always changing your gear or your pedals, you cannot have your own sound. Also, man, you save lots of money. If you're buying 1 or 2 new pedals every month, How much money would you save at the end of the year? Certainly a couple of grands, man. That's a lot of money. But the most important is the time that you will save. Man, if I spend those 20 hours a week looking for a gear, and instead I practiced my guitar, instead I practiced to become a better musician, work on my musicality, compose a lot more songs. That's a lot of things that I could have done, but instead I was looking for gear, and I'm not really going anywhere in my music career if I just like look for gear. So what I want to say, guys, is that it's all about music, and I'm not saying that you should not buy pedals as of now. You should just set yourself some goals. So now you should open a page on your computer, write a wish list of all the pedals you want to get, and eventually buy them and stick to them. Instead of thinking of, oh, I could get another pedal that would be better for my sound. No, because there's always like a moment where the magic disappears. After a week of getting a new pedal, you start thinking, hey, I could get something else, but you have to remember that you really wanted this pedal a week ago. Like, you have to always have that in the back of your head when you play with your pedals, even if you have it since a week or since 2 years or 10 years, you have to remember that you really wanted this piece of gear, and you should let this pedal inspire you to play better, to become a better musician, to create your own sound with it. So write yourself a wish list, buy those pedals, and stick to them. And remember, it's always about music, guys. So maybe some people will ask me, oh, but will you do some more gear videos on your channel? Is this the end of your gear videos? No, because I like doing them. But my channel is about music. I have like 140 videos, I think, and I estimate that a little more than 100 of them, hundreds of them are about music. And that's very sad because 90% of my subscribers come from my gear videos. And that's not a great thing. But I hope you have subscribed on a gear video, but you will stay for the music. And I hope I can inspire some people that can relate to this. Remember, it's all about music. Now this video is already too long, so that's it for today. And thanks, guys. See you on the next video. Bye.